Hello everyone and welcome to Think Python. Today I'll talk about built-in modules. Python has its own library which has hundreds of built-in modules. And just to refresh, module is a file that contains related functions and classes. So let's go to this library and see all the modules that we have. To see the modules in indexed manner, go to your browser, type Python along with the version. So I have Python 3. Module index. Hit enter. Click on the first result. There you go. So you have this Python module index, and as you can see, there are so many modules that we have all alphabetically arranged. So we'll not go into the details of all the modules, and here you can explore it at your own level. If you want, you can click on the particular module to know its details, right? And you don't have to know all the modules because nobody actually knows all the modules. So you'll come to know about them as you'll progress in your Python coding journey. Okay, so let's learn about some of these modules which we have. So back to our PyCharm, and here I have my work.py file. Okay, so here I'll show you one module. Let us say, as I mentioned, that these are built-in modules. You don't have to make a file, but it's already there in the Python library. And if you want to see this, click on the project panel. In the project panel, when you scroll down, click on external libraries, Python 3.8, and you have this Python 3.8 library root. So when you click on this, you'll have a list of modules with the extension of .py. So these are all the modules that you can see, and in case you are interested in the source code of any of the module, you can simply double click it, and there you go, you have the complete source code. So as of now, we are not interested in this, so we'll simply learn how to use these modules. Okay, so I'll minimize this project window. And to use a module, first of all, we need to import it, right? So I'll import a module called random. Hit enter. And then when you type random, with the help of a dot operator, you can have a list of all the methods that are there inside this module, right? So here I'll call this random.random. Now this random.random will give me a random number between 0 and 1. So if I print this here, and let's run the code. So at the output, we have this random number which is generated between 0 and 1. So if you run the code again, so the random number changes, but it will lie between 0 and 1. One more time, we have a new random number. So let us say if you want to generate 3 random numbers, then you can always put this print statement inside a for loop. So here I'll say for I in range 5. Let me indent this, right? And if I now run the code, so I have these 5 random numbers generated between 0 and 1, right? Similarly, one more time. So every time you run the code, we have different set of 5 random numbers. Now for example, you don't want to generate a random number between 0 and 1, but you want to generate between some other two integers. So for that, we have one more method, which is rand int, which stands for random integer. So again, with the help of the dot operator, random integer. Now here I need to specify the numbers between which I want to generate. So you can see this small tooltip here. Here A is highlighted, so I enter 10, comma. Now B is highlighted, so I enter 20. That means I want random numbers to be generated between 10 and 20. And I run the code, so I have this 5 random numbers generated. Run it one more time, a new set of 5 random numbers, so like that. Okay, So this is how we can use to generate the floats between 0 and 1 using the random module and integers between any two limits that you specify here. Now there's one more method which you can use, where you can select a particular item randomly from a list. I'll show you how. So I'll keep this import random statement here as it is, and I define a list of fruits. So I'll say mango and orange, plum, one more, maybe grapes. Okay, now I want to select a random fruit out of this using the random module. So I'll call this module by random dot choice, and I'll pass my list name as the attribute. So the name of my list is fruits, perfect. And because this is going to return me a random value out of this list, so I need to store it somewhere here. So I'll define this as favorite fruit, and it will get stored here. And if we print favorite fruit and I run the code, let's see what we get at the output. Slide this up. So this is randomly picking grapes. Run it one more time. Grapes again. One more time. Again grapes. Something wrong. It really likes grapes. And this time it is plum. So every time it is picking up a random item from the list that you have specified here. Okay. So this is how you can work with the built-in libraries of Python. Once again, you don't have to remember all the libraries, all the modules, because as you go on programming, depending on your application and the particular project you're working on, you will only work on that particular module, right? So keep practicing, keep moving forward. If you have any doubts, post it in the comment section so that we discuss on it and resolve it. Till we meet in the next session, have a good day. Bye-bye.